everybody, Super Strider here, and it's been a little while. I meant to do an episode of this last week, but never got around to it. Didn't have free time, and on the free time I did had, I had a tooth pulled!
And it was disgusting as shit.
Yeah, you saw the picture, didn't you?
Oh yeah, why the hell did you send me that?
Because I said I would?
The fuck, bro?
At least talk a little louder since you're all the way over there building a shelf for some reason.
Yeah, go fuck yourself, bro. Go fuck yourself. This is good-ass construction shit, okay? Don't fucking question my methods. I will shove this black pole so far up your ass.
Alright. We're already, like, I think we're halfway through the game already. I'm not exactly sure, but I know there's going to be at least two more, if not three more parts of this series. Let's just get started. So we're going to enter the next area. And I'm just doing some things real quick. And then other news, I'm recording this on the 30th, but I don't know if this is going to go up on the 31st or the 1st.
Hey,
is it? Yes, it's the 30th, because tomorrow's my birthday!
Oh, right. Tomorrow's payday for me.
I turn 31 tomorrow.
That is kind of fucked up if you look at it. You turn 31 on March 31st.
It's going to be the start of my golden year. Well, then I'm not looking forward to Saturday because, well, that's April Fool's Day, and I'll get into that in a bit and why I don't like April Fool's Day. Let's get started, shall we? Well, we've been wasting enough time.
What? You don't like April Fool's Day because you might think I'd come back with Fetty Patty?
No. You're going to have to come over here for me to tell this story. All right, let's get started. We're about to enter the next area. We just got the A key. And now we're in a big giant tree limb. I don't know how to describe this place.
Think of the old lady that lives in a shoe.
This does not look like that! Come over here so you can actually see what's on screen!
I don't want to come over here, dammit! Don't yell at me, Grandpa!
Stop calling me Grandpa, dammit!
You're old. You're old.
Stab, 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 stab.
You and Matt are the oldest friends I have. It's like you and freaking General are the oldest friends I have. Wait, how old the hell is General?
He's a couple years older than I am.
Holy shit, he is an old man. Both of you are.
He's like 32 or 33.
You're both old men. I'm 23. I'm still young as shit.
I am free from injury because of the ointment. Oh, we can also get the best, or my favorite sword in the game in this episode.
Oh, you mean that, I'm not gonna freaking say it and spoil it, that sword?
Yeah, because it's in the next town. I can buy it. And I'm pretty sure I already have enough gold.
Just imagine that was in Skyrim. That'd be a giant fuck you to
It's probably a mod!
That'd be a giant fuck you to a dragon. Come here, dragon!
Well, the best sword in the game is the Dragon Slayer, and you actually get that from the King of Dwarves, who is a dragon. Figure that out.
Is this in Skyrim, dammit?
Oh, I can't get the food. So, you're wondering... I'll grab you a seat so you can sit down for this story. You're wondering why I do not like April Fool's Day.
Yes, please enlighten me. I wouldn't make the same damn mistake when I do it.
Because I actually I was traumatized on an April Fool's Day.
This I gotta hear.
My sophomore year in high school, or no, not my sophomore, junior year in high school, on April Fool's Day, I went to the bus stop as normal.
Oh, wait!
I've probably told you the story before, but the audience has not heard this, so I want them to hear it.
Damn.
Yeah.
Fucked up.
Yeah. I go to the bus stop as normal.
No.
Except there's a bit of a major difference this particular day.
Keep in mind. When people say, if people don't know what the hell Gary is, Gary's the new Chicago. And Chicago's technically in the new ghetto land of Gary.
But I lived in Black Oak, which was actually one of the safe parts of Gary.
That ain't shit! Gary ain't safe shit! It's Chicago. Hammond ain't even safe, because we got people from Chicago coming over to Gary, coming over to Hammond, trying to act stupid as shit.
Yeah, I grew up in Gary, Indiana, which was, I remember one of the teachers that my brother had described this town as the armpit of America.
In which case, when Chicago...
Oh yeah, I'm about to fight a boss.
No, when Chicago came over, like the ghetto part of Chicago came over to Gary, it became the ass crack of America.
Well, back to the story. Oh, we're fighting a boss. It's this guy again. I'm just gonna kill him with death. Alright, so, back to the story. I go to the bus stop, and I notice something strange. I notice a lot of flashing lights when I was a block away, because we have to walk a block and a half to get to it. Back to the game, but I just picked up the battle helmet, which is the best shield in the game. Figure that out. It counts as a shield, but I cannot equip it yet unless I have all three pieces of the suit.
Sounds just like Soul Calibur.
I go to the bus stop. There are flashing lights there. I get closer. There are police officers there, police squad cars, and paramedics.
This is the best way to fuck. This is the best way to fuck up your whole entire school year. Keep in mind, this is the best way to actually go to school and just said, I've had nightmares with this shit.
Yeah, this is grade A. What I'm about to say is grade A nightmare fuel. In the yard, at my bus stop, because it was at a corner. It was at a corner on the street, right next to a person's house. Laying in the yard. Some crazed asshole shot his girlfriend in the head, execution style, and left her body in the yard. At the yard where kids go to go get on the bus to be picked up from school.
Obviously,
high school, middle school, and elementary school all use that same bus stop. He left it there as a statement.
Okay, now here's...
Where God and everyone could see it.
Now, here's a statement. Women, this is what happens when you go for thugs instead of nice guys like us.
I've touched the poison. So, bearing witness to that, not only that, but also to the fact that it happened on an April Fool's Day. So when I eventually went to school, which I still do not know to this day why I didn't turn around and head straight home and just tell my mom, no, I'm not going to school today, because I might die, no, and just hide from the world. This was like 11 or 12 years ago. I don't remember why I didn't do it, but I just didn't do it. but when I eventually went there, I went to school and I was telling everybody what I had witnessed. No one would believe me, because they all thought it was an April Fool's joke that I was telling. Until it got to the point where I would break down and start crying in front of them and just saying, why would I make this up? If you've never experienced seeing something like that before, I don't care what how old you are. While you're still a minor, that will mess you up for life.
Here's the fucked up version. You saw a murder on April. It's like you saw something on April Fool's. I literally watched my cousin and technically one of my classmates' cousin and a friend of ours technically die right across the apartment from us, in my old house. Literally.
How?
Obviously shooting. Don't know how the hell this
happened. We live in a nice place, don't we?
Don't know how the hell this happened. Here's how it goes. Goes in. Twisted jackass decided he's gonna do this. He's gonna tie the body up. He's like, tie the bodies up loosely with bullet holes to it to make it almost look like the bodies are.
By the way. So. There it is. We have our title fork, folks. We have our title.
Yes, Indiana.
Fork on a stick.
I'm serious, I want to look that up and see if there's actually a mod in Skyrim for that shit.
Alright, let's go equip it.
But I want to see if there's a giant ass fucking silverware of a spoon and knife.
There we go, now I have my battle fork.
Anyway, back to my story.
There's no key shop here.
Here's the fucked up part. This happened 3 days before Christmas. Yes, December 22nd. this shit happened 3 days before Christmas. In which case, I was literally right across the hall from my cousin's house.
Ow.
That actually got shot. And technically, yeah. This is why I don't go to funerals. Never again. I've been to like 6 funerals in my, like, possibly, I don't know, it's been a
while. I've been to a few too, myself.
I've been to a few, but this is why I don't go to funerals. If you ask me to go to funerals, I'm like looking at you like, hail to the no.
Hail to the no, to the no, no, no.
Oh yeah, here's the thing. One is like, not. I had 2 choices when I was younger. And this is what my choices, what my parents were giving me. Either, I didn't go to my cousin's funeral. I was pissed off, literally, I was a kid, ready to exact revenge on any poor bastard that actually came my way. Literally, I was the type of person that said I want a person with a gun to come with me because I'm about to kill his ass too. And send his ass to hell with me. Mind you, I'm a kid, so yeah.
Hi. Hi there.
Jump across, it wants to give you a hug.
Poke you in the eye.
Anyway. I was a kid, mind you, so nearly half our lives have been fucked up, and I've been given a choice by my parents. Enjoy my life as a kid, and go to Navy Pier with my class, or go to a funeral. Obviously, I chose Navy Pier. My mom was trying to force me to go to a funeral, and I didn't want to go. My dad said, well, it's like, women don't truly scar that boy. It's like, look, we can worry about this when he's older. When he's a kid, he doesn't need to be around this crap.
Tentacruel again.
So, yeah. I've had shit happen to me in my life that's fucked up. We do not live in a nice area because, look, we live right by Tanglewood. And if you notice the story of Tanglewood...
I don't know anything about that place.
Do not become a delivery driver. I shit you not. Do not deliver to Tanglewood. That is my advice to you. The reason why... Tanglewood decided, oh yeah, delivery guy that was going to, is like just 16 years old, got his had his car, got his first job, and his parent is like, and his dad decided, since you actually did good in school, got good grades, and you got your first job, I'm going to buy you a Mustang. What happened was, this is when they say Garrett's becoming the new Chicago, and now you have people of Chicago trying to come to Hammond and trying to screw it up for us. Thing they did was, he worked at Pizza Hut, hand delivered pizza to them, and then knocked on the door. Nope, they ended up shooting him. Taking his money, taking his shoes, taking his car, and taking everything else. And leaving him right by the dumpster.
They shot him.
Yes, when you open the door and someone's holding a gun to your face, what the hell do you think they're gonna do? Automatically, when he opened it, it's like when he opened the door, this is what he was staring at, the end of a gun before he got shot in the head. So yes, this story is kind of dark. The era that we live in is kind of dark. And now they're doing some stupid shit again where they're trying to break into people's cars.
Well, I don't own a car, so I don't have to worry about that.
I want them to try to do that.
Folks of you who are wondering what I'm doing right now, I'm just farming hourglasses right here.
Actually, no, they actually tried to do that with my Cadillac.
While we're talking about all this dark, depressing stuff.
It's raining outside. No, we need to switch to rainbows and sunshine and possibly anime tentacle one time.
I second that. either that, or we're gonna look. Because we're depressed right now. Editor's note right now. At this point in time, because I'm gonna cut this together later. Put up our favorite picture again.
I need to Google search it again.
Google search. I thought you saved it to your phone.
I did, but when I sent it to you, my phone was too big. It's like my phone laughed so hard it deleted it.
Well, it's still on my hard drive.
It's like my phone laughed so hard it shut down on itself.
By the way, I hate this screen.
I was going to tell you.
Here, I'll show you why. Because that blue bastard.
when you go down here, because this is going to... I'm going to get a secret item right now. There's another reason why I picked up all those, of those hourglasses, because I'm going to need two of them. One for this item, and one for a boss later.
The perfect way to hide. This is like almost a ninja village.
This is the branches of the world tree. But we're on this screen. I've got the magical rod.
No,
all right.
No. In which case, if you look at it, this is kind of like the... this is actually kind of like a freaking ninja village. The village hidden in the trees.
Man, you're such a Narutard.
Fuck you. Naruto's awesome.
By the way, what were we talking about? Oh, yeah, the picture. Wait, it's already been shown. Yeah, there you go, folks. We have some lols. And by the way, we gotta fight this guy again.
Also, if you want to know what the hell that picture looks like, look up Black Sumo Wrestlers. I got bored one day, just looked that up and just found that picture and then found...
No, it was in the first episode, dude!
I know. I got bored, I looked up that picture and I found, like, Black Sumo Wrestlers that are real, and then I found that picture of that...
I want that picture to be a meme now.
Of that skinny guy, it is like, just imagine that boss was that picture. Just imagine. That boss is that picture.
There, I've got the battle suit. Now all I need is the Dragon Slayer, then I can actually wear all three. But the Dragon Slayer is not until the next area. The game eventually tells you this, but at the meantime, you can't wear it, so...
I will not lie, Google is your best friend to search anything you want.
Stop jumping!
Google is your best friend. Here's what's going to be in the description.
There's that bird thing again.
Here's what's going to be in the description. What in the giant hell?
What?
It's like they're trying to do Swan Lake.
One sumo wrestler body slamming another.
That is 400 pounds of god dang.
This is why I hate this screen, because that bastard right there. Watch what he does. We need to try to climb up. Oh. Ah, there we go.
Oh, so he stabs you. He's like a...
No, and he knocks you down. That's the problem. There's a reason why I got the, I was farming the, hourglasses.
I just saw a side...
I'm gonna sacrifice half my little bit of health I got.
I just saw a side view of this shit that actually made me laugh. Here's the side view of this shit! Why are you even trying, son? Just why are you trying?
And it wore off. I don't want to die. I want to get to the next dungeon. Or the next area.
I'm sorry, just imagine you guys, like, just imagine you had to fight that. Just imagine you had to fight this. You're going to die. He's just going to sit on you. I was about to say, is that a woman sumo wrestler?
No, it's a dude.
Yeah, but the way he was...
Alright, I got farm health real quick.
Yeah, but the way he was bending down here, like, not... Nope. Dude. You're not gonna believe this shit.
What?
They exist.
Black female sumo wrestlers? Why wouldn't they?
Only female sumo wrestler.
Well, it's not mutually exclusive. I'm surprised more of them don't exist. It's a legitimate sport.
I'm sorry, this is horrible. This is horrible. This is totally horrible!
Little girl going head to head with the sumo wrestler.
This is horrible!
That's actually, he's probably just playing along, or it could be like a... I don't know the story about it. It could just be like she won the option, like playing with a sports star or something like that, because, again, sumo wrestling is a sport.
Yes, it is, but dude, that's a little girl.
And she probably watches it.
And if she's like Superman, she picks that big fat ass up, I'd be happy as hell if that was my daughter. Matter of fact, I'm gonna get my daughter into wrestling early.
Another reason why I was farming for gold.
Just so she can buddy slam her uncle.
I shall give you a title, Myrmidon. Make sure you live up to it.
The hell is you that need title?
Myrmidon.
The fuck is a Myrmidon?
I don't know what that means. You got like... the phone to Google it! That's how you spell it!
Hold on. What the hell is that?
Myrmidon.
Hold on. Man, that sounds like Mastodon. Like, that sounds like Mastodon fucked up. Hold on. I'd be laughing if that's some kind of dinosaur. The rejected Power Rangers.
Apparently the new movie is supposed to be pretty decent.
I'm about to watch that shit because I got a website that watches that shit for free. Myrmidon, a member of the warlike Thessalonian people, led by Achilles at the Surge of Troy. Hmm.
Did you find the magic cane? Yes, I have it. You are the famous warrior. You are as good looking as I've heard.
Gay.
No, that was a woman who was asked telling me that, dude.
She's trying to get in your pants. I thought that was a guy. Be real fucked up right about now if a guy said, yeah, guess what, you're hot.
Daybreak is a town at the border. Oh, yeah, this is the town of Daybreak.
Shit.
Yeah, don't play that.
No, what happened was I was, YouTube is sensitive.
The guru of Conflate has the ring of dwarves. So I have to go back to the previous town.
Well, that's funny as hell.
So, I'm prepping real quick. Because this is why we have to backtrack, people. Really? We can do the next dungeon in this episode because this area is actually pretty short once I realized it. We've only been going for 22 minutes and we're already almost done.
I'm sorry, I wasn't paying attention. I was going back to building.
And just to backtrack is only going to take a couple minutes.
Can you still eat solid... can you even eat solid food?
Yes, I can eat solid foods again.
Oh, I was about to say.
It's been long enough.
I was going to be a jackass and eat an Oreo cookie.
I don't have enough! That is the best spell in the game. I will have enough when I come back.
What the hell is that best spell?
Tilte. It's basically, I'll show you when I get it.
I will not lie, that sounds like a Pokemon move, or a Pokemon.
I don't know how you pronounce it! Alright. Buy one of these because we're going to need it.
Go back. Let me see what the hell his name is.
T-I-L-T-E. That's how you spell it.
Tilte?
T-I-L-T-E. Tilt or Tilt. I have no idea how you pronounce it.
That sounds like a fucking Pokemon, though. Tilty, I choose you! Quick! Use Aerial Ace! That sounds like a flying type Pokemon.
Alright, we got to go back to the previous dungeon or town.
You're about to say tundra, weren't you?
Dungeon. Blah, 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 blah.
It's raining.
Oh, screw you, you blue alien-looking dude.
It's not an alien, it's a Yoshi. A blue Yoshi.
No, they actually look like the alien from Aliens.
You mean butt ugly Martians? Seriously, we actually got rid of a shitload of cartoons that were actually we grew up with. That had a lot of sexual innuendos in it.
Hey, dude, I remember in the first few of our seasons of Pokemon, they had some innuendos in that.
I still can't believe they banned that motherfucker, though. James having boobs. for those that don't know that...
Yes!
shut the hell up. For those that don't know, they had a bad Pokemon episode where it was like a bikini contest between Jesse, Mist is like the flat-chested Missy,
and James
that somehow end up growing boobs.
Which is why James's disguises are actually pretty awesome.
I will not lie.
I've seen that gif, man. It's hilarious.
I have too.
Got showed up with a transvestite with big tits.
Look, I shit you not, I seen the episode and that was funny as hell. I don't know how, but he made them grow to, like, double D's. To Jesse looking like, holy shit, those are...
I'm probably going to get that picture up, and it's going up right now.
Look, I shit you not, to the point where Jesse was looking like, we got this in a bag. Misty was actually looking at her chest and crying. Now that her...
I'm probably just going to Google James with boobs, and it's going to pop up.
I will not lie, someone...
That was funny.
I will not lie, someone created Rule 63 of this shit. They were like, when they seen that banned episode, yes. Double yes. Rule 63 of this shit.
It's a trap. But no, I was talking about, the other one I was thinking of is when they go to that one town that's infected with the Grimers and has the Magnemites everywhere. Where apparently the one Magnemite is following Pikachu around because he has a cold and is emitting electromagnetic pulse while doing so every time he sneezes. And Ash comments, the Magnemite's following Pikachu around him like he's some kind of streaker. And Misty's face just gets the teardrops like, oh, you did not just say what I thought you said. And Brock corrects him with saying, you mean stalker, Ash.
You gotta realize.
But do you not know what a streaker is, Ash?
Look, you gotta realize.
Don't rely on your magic power alone during the last fight against the dwarfs.
You can wear
the battle helmet and battle suit only when you have the Dragon Slayer. You will not be able to return us the Dragon Slayer until we have true peace here. This ring will open the door to Dartmoor. Take it with you.
Actually,
ring of... There's a bit of English!
When the hell was this game made? By a 5-year-old?
This was made in 1988, or localized here in 1988.
This is before they even had Internet Explorer. Or spell correct. It was like, correct. Damn, no wonder. It's like, no wonder is our generation stupid as shit.
Alright, now I gotta get Telltale, which I'm gonna need that for the last, or with the next two bosses.
No. It's like, you gotta realize something.
You know what? Since there's not a whole lot left, let's do a little extra long episode and just finish the game in this episode.
Alright, okay.
Because we're already near that, well, I'm gonna at least tackle the next dungeon, though the last one is a bit of a maze. It depends on how long we've been recording, so... It depends. I may make a separate episode for the final dungeon. We'll see how long the next one does.
But should we stop the recording? We're like 28 minutes in, or no? Just keep going.
All right. Well, you know what? I'm gonna pause it real quick because we've already been going for half an hour. I'll be back at the other town because I just have to go there, and besides, I'm going to be farming for gold anyway, just so I can buy that spell. I'll be back in a couple minutes.
I also got to tell you why the hell Ash actually said that. It's going to be fucking funny.
Alright, so I'll see you in a minute. And we're back! It didn't take very long, did it?
No, we were actually talking about some shit.
We're talking about Power Rangers, actually.
And the reason why Ash actually said that. Here's the thing.
Why Ash said a streaker instead of stalker?
Yeah, it's like, no, like, here's the fucked up part. As you pulled up, Ash's mom is actually fucking that Mr. Mott.
I pointed that out. It's called pokephilia, folks. Look, it's an actual thing.
Here's the thing, though. We also see in the episode when Ash comes home, the reason why Pikachu gets sent to Professor Oak's lab, and Mr. Mott gets sent on a long-ass fucking delivery. Oh, yeah, Ash's mom is like...
I don't know how you pronounce that, I don't care.
Also, look, here's the fucked up part.
It's the Ariel Hadouken, that's all I know it is.
Here's the fucked up part, and funny as hell. When Ash comes home,
There goes all my money.
there's a lot of incest possibly involved.
No, she is not. She.
You sure?
Ash has never touched a woman.
You sure about that? Is like, you sure about that, man? Because look, his mom is like, look, He's never touched a woman because his mom scared the shit out of actually half the women that he's with. Obviously. Ash's mom is a yonder saying, "You will not take my baby from me, motherfucker." That's what
you're putting in a lot of other things. You're going to other areas.
I shit you not. Think about this. If you look at a Pokemon now that actually had like, Tirana, is like Serena and all that. Sheila is like, she remembers Ash. But we don't remember her in the original Pokemon story. This is like later in Kalos region.
I haven't watched it since Johto.
It's like, this is like Unova / Kalos region and all that
That's
shit.
That's probably why I outgrew the show.
And now if you look at it, she moved away a long ass time ago. Ash's mom said something to her mom.
Stab the eyeball noodle.
Come to
me. Alright, next area. Let's go.
It's basically Ash's mom just told her. It's like,
the walls are brains!
Dude, shut the fuck up and let me finish it. Ash's mom told Posse Serena's mom, "If your daughter comes near my baby, I'm going to kill you both." So that's why they probably moved a long ass time ago. And why Ash's mom goes through mood swings every time Ash leaves on a
journey. I have never seen Ash's mom in a mood swing.
You never know that shit? That's when he leaves. You don't see the band shit when she stays. She's doing this. She's playing technically Russian roulette with a knife.
The knife game. Oh, ding, yeah. Ding, 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 ding.
Like, I feel a
this
disturbance.
This got dark, like, man.
It's like, I feel a disturbance. It's like, I feel a disturbance. Some hussy's trying to take my baby.
Next town.
Like, the first minute he comes, is like, first minute she comes around, I'm going to have to stab a bitch.
Nope. Last town in the game.
So I kind of believe
I shall give you a title. Champion!
So I kind of believe that shit.
Alright, I got my spawn point here.
If you look at it, Pokemon don't show it, but damn it, if we saw some banned episodes of this shit, Ash's mom would show you.
No, I don't need to go here.
Show traces
keys
of
keys are pointless now. No more keys are needed throughout the rest of the game, I believe. I need to buy some items.
I shit you not, if we actually watch some banned episodes, just like that freaking banned episode.
I just got a promotion. Time to kill myself! I'm gonna bait this dead joke like a dead horse! Come on!
Put up a fight, dammit.
No! I'm deliberately doing this!
I set
my spawn point there.
No, I'd be laughing if this game said, "No, I do die too much." Fuck
yeah, I just
point.
Lost. I only lost 600 experience, but I gained 9,000 gold.
It's over. We need to make the joke.
It's not over 9,000 yet.
Get the joke. It's like, get some more damn gold. Start spawning. We need to make the joke.
There you go.
It's over 9,000.
Oh, speaking of something that happened this earlier this week, when I was at the college on Tuesday, someone was playing Street Fighter 4 on their laptop, on the big screen. Since he's playing the Steam version, he's playing with mods. He has character model mods. Guess what he replaced both Dan and Rufus with?
I don't know, but I want to know this right now.
Hercule and Majin Buu! It was awesome!
Oh my god!
Dan has an alternate costume that makes him he's Hercule!
It's like those punches will feel like a massage.
And you wanna know what's funny? I played Dan both times and won both fights!
You got lucky!
Because I'm actually good with Dan!
You got lucky! Oh my goodness, those punches feel like a massage from Hercule!
All right, I was gonna buy some more healing items.
Oh my god, dude!
How many items?
I kind of want to see a mod like that now in freaking Soul. It's like in a fighting game of Soul Calibur.
I've already seen some of the alternate skins. Akuma's custom skin that he imported was Cyber Akuma. From the first MVC.
Hold on. Cyber Akuma sounds OP.
Yes, Chun-Li's alternate was Morgan.
For those that don't know, Chun-Li is Black Storm's waifu. Everyone asks me this question, why the hell would I go for Chun-Li? Those, that is like them.
Ken was Jin Kazama, for some reason.
Who?
For Tekken.
Wait. Who was Jin Kazama?
Ken.
No, Ryu should be more Jin
Kazama. No, Ryu actually had something else. I forget what it was. Sakura was Hinata, not from Naruto, the Hinata from Rival Schools, which is Sakura's best friend. For Rival Schools and Project Justice.
We need to start playing Project Justice. we need to. He always kicked my ass with the Powerpuff
Ninjas. No, I have to explain that. I have a team in Project Justice. It consists of three Momos, and their colors are red, green, and pink. Pink, green, and blue. I call them the Powerpuff Girls.
Here's where the one pixelated life comes into play. I was going to kick his ass. Nope.
And
it's like, nope, all three fucking Powerpuff Girls turned into a wheel and actually ended up going.
I did the party up technique.
I'm like, what?
Everyone hates
fuck?
It when I play as that team because I do it just for the lulz.
I hate you when you play as that team.
By the way, we still haven't commented. The background is brains here.
It ain't brains, that's red bricks. That's like your blood intestines.
No, it looks like brains, man. So we're going to the second to last. Ow! Stop it! Stop it!
He just wanted to stab you. I find that funny, he's following your ass.
Back away, Minotaur. Man.
I find that funny as hell that he's following your ass. He's like, oh, there's that bitch at.
Staff, I hate these guys.
I would not lie.
Kill the noodle.
If you look at it, Hercules, like, no, Hercules is almost like a joke character for some fucked up case.
Alright, now we're the second to last dungeon.
And the reason why I say he's some joke-ass character, because if you watch Dragon Ball Super, he decided, he's like, nah. He was pulling some bullshit saying that he was the one that kicked Beerus' ass and turned Super Saiyan to do it. Yes. Yes, he looks like freaking Bubble Bowl. He was like, oh yeah, he's like, oh yeah, Beerus couldn't stand my freaking power. I just powered up on his ass.
Yeah, sure, Hercule, whatever.
I know for a fact... Someone is like, I know for a fact.
I'm like, you lost all your credibility, man.
Look, Elder Kai was looking like this. Basically, Kabuto Kai was looking like this.
What? All right.
Everyone fears Beerus.
No. They're still fused because I thought that was only in GT.
No, they've been fused.
Oh no. Oh, yeah, that's right because they figured it. They didn't know how the Potara worked.
In which case,
and then they figured it out the hard way.
In which case, it's kind of like this. They kind of fuse forever because...
Yeah, because
Elder
apparently...
Kai is like, Elder Kai kind of left some shit out about... He just forgot how to fuse because he fused with an old-ass witch.
Oh, here we go. There's the giant sperm again.
I'm going to eat your oval eggs.
I believe this is a screen with the ointment on it, if I'm not mistaken. I will try a couple of times to see if it spawns.
No, we should put this in the description. Yes, this title has some dark themes to this shit.
There it is, yeah. It does spawn here.
Like, no.
Invincibility, lol!
We said we were going to try to insult game or try to get him to play a Naruto game.
I have to go there eventually, but not yet.
Seriously, Strider, we should get you to play Naruto. No, this is what Naruto games need. We need a clashing back. Remember my old PS2? Yes, I had Naruto Uzumaki, and then someone had, like, freaking Sasuke. He put a fireball, I hit dynamic entry. Yes, only in PS2 and the Narutos of old when we clashed. We didn't care about fighting. We just cared about clashing.
Alright, I'm actually... Okay, it wore off. I'm gonna farm for life for a little bit, because I know the boss that's coming up, and he... Yeesh. It's one of the few bosses that actually is dangerous and a legit threat. It's actually this boss I'm about to come up is harder than the final boss, actually. So, sadly enough.
It's basically like Cyber Okumo. He just OPs your ass. I'm sorry. It's like, I'm sorry. Cyber Okumo? That sounds too OP right there, damn it. Like, oh yeah, Cyber Okumo. Before the match even begins, just one shot. It's like ultimate move all matter.
Alright, here's the screen. This is not the boss I was talking to. I'm talking about there is a stop it! Stop with the ghosts!
Who are you gonna call? Ghostbusters!
And I touched the poison. And it knocked me back, damn it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it!
They keep smoking.
Quit it! Quit it!
No. I don't wanna die. It's like, I don't wanna die. Stay away, stay away, stay away, stay away, stay away. They keep spamming from that one.
I used the wing boots just so I could just say screw this. Reason why I have hourglasses is this guy! The king of the dwarves!
I will not lie, that looks like a fucking mix between a dragon and a beetle.
Okay, there's a reason why I use the hourglass, so he doesn't do his fireballs that hurt like crazy.
So basically that one shot your ass.
Yes, there's a reason Wing boots is worn off.
So those fireballs just end up one-shotting you.
Yeah, no, they do a lot of damage, even with my shield.
Oh, hell.
No! Healing! Healing! Healing now!
He's going to one-shot your poor ass. And the damage has already been done.
I took one. But the problem with the hourglass is it drains you by drains half your health to activate it. Because it's so OP.
No! What's OP is like if this person just had a Kumo shot. It's like...
It wore off already?! Why would I not?! I just realized I was... I'm just using up all my hourglasses, screw it! There we go! I've got the Dragon Slayer! Use it up. Screw it, use it up!
I need one more potion. I would say equip that armor right about now. Equip everything.
Oh, glitch that happens, you get a second hand dagger for some reason. Alright, now I have the best equipment in the game equipped! And for some reason, the dragon, the battle helmet counts as a shield again. Oh, it's still in effect? You want to be his voice?
Hold on. The monster you've just defeated is King Grieve. The King of the Dwarves.
The evil.
The evil one changed his appearance.
Okay, that's why he looks like a damn dragon.
The King of Protected... Wait. The King of Protected Sword. The sword from the evil one. By hiding it within his own body. Use the sword to defeat the evil one in this fortress. This will open the door. It's like, open the door to the fortress.
The demon's ring. Okay, back to town.
Yeah, that's the best way to, like, screw it. I'm gonna swallow my freaking sacred sword.
Actually, you know what? I'm gonna take the shortcut back. Again! I abused this mechanic for all it's worth! Wait. Doesn't matter. Yeah. Hurry up!
It's a slow, agonizing death.
I'll take the XP loss, I don't care. Alright, we're back here, so now I have to buy lots and lots of potions!
I'm actually kind of, it's like, no, I just realized, there is like, no, I was watching Samurai Jack, it became awesome.
I haven't seen it when it came back, so.
This one, actually.
But then again, look, I don't have cable, so.
Look, here's the thing. You know the cartoon version where it would just show mechanics dying? Like, machines dying? This time it shows Jack actually cutting a human's throat. It shows blood, man!
It showed blood back then, too, dude! Jack bled back in the original series.
Yes.
That series didn't mess around, man.
No, it's like, no, this one he kind of...
I still remember the very first episode where he took down those robots and he just went completely and utterly psycho.
Look, you should see this one. It's like, look, he's basically facing the cult of Aku. It's like Aku, which is almost like the daughters of Aku and all that shit. Nope, he just does like this look. I give you a choice.
What do they got for Aku now? Because Mako's dead. And he was the original voice.
I don't know. I gotta realize that shit, but yeah. They got the same person for Jack, I think.
It's just, they can't literally, they can't use the same voice actor for Aku because the original voice actor is dead. Alright, time to die again.
I don't know, but yeah. Obviously,
go faster! Die quicker! That took forever!
Look, if that's the case in most fighting games, when I fight you in, just stand still so I can actually kick your ass.
The only negative thought is that took forever! Alright. we're gonna finish the game in this episode, screw it. We're already almost done.
I will not lie, I was laughing.
We'll make this only a 3-part series, I don't care.
I was actually laughing my ass off at something. If anyone is a fan of Sword Art Online, you gotta watch The Abridged. It's funny as shit. As a matter of fact, you gotta watch The Abridged of any anime. It is funny as shit. Especially Yu-Gi-Oh!
That's how it started. That was the first Abridged series.
No, but it's more funny as hell because if you look at it, it's like this. Oh, yeah. Person's like, the person that fought the Pharaoh, he's like, nothing you do will surprise me. Oh, yeah? I bet I can jump this gorge with this horse. You can't. You're a horsey! Look, horsey takes a freaking, is like, horsey's doing like a windmill 360 backflip into the gorge.
Oh, yeah, speaking of Abridged. The latest episode just came out.
I gotta watch that. Don't slow.
You haven't seen it yet?
I've been busy, damn it. I've just been busy. I actually wanted to get, like, time to watch this shit, but I've been busy.
I have it on my laptop.
Okay, we'll watch this after the show.
when we're done recording, yeah, we'll watch it.
Look.
But we'll go back to the Abridged jokes.
I will not lie. Look, it was funny as hell. It's like when the chorus went down to the gorge and all that shit. You just saw freaking Pharaoh just saying this. Okay. That actually did surprise me. No lie. Then when it's like, no, when Pharaoh freaking lost, you got Joey's like, no, you got, so... it's like, you got Tristan saying this. Yugi will come out on top any minute now. Nope, he's watching this blast happen where all Dark Magician Girl, and technically all his monsters that he sacrificed are just saying, fuck you. About to blast his ass into oblivion.
I hate the bees.
In which case, it's like, no lie, in which
the
case...
stupid bee die!
In which case, Tristan is like this. Yep, any second now, Yugi will always win. Any second now.
Alright.
Any second. Nope, life points went to zero.
Like, okay.
Yugi, are you okay?
Oh, come here! Look what this door does. That's all it does! And we're in the final area, and the first thing we see is a dick.
No, it's like, no, if you see two of them. Look, you see the front view, you see the side view, you see the absolute length of it, and technically you see some short Chinese guys.
Alright, so this place is actually a maze, and I don't exactly remember how to get through it,
or
the most quickest path, but this actually will take about maybe 10 minutes left. Or maybe 10 minutes.
If we're lucky.
So, this is an area that shows all the monsters you have faced before, and they're all in screens.
And they're all, it's like, look, they're just firing at you, dude.
Stop it. Down. Oh yeah, this error, or these screens actually loop too. And it's also, you notice that the music's slightly different.
Buddy, you're trying to hit something that's not there.
And we're back at the start.
On the giant dick. On the medium.
And I touched the poison again. But there's a reason why I bought the 8 red potions. I'm taking this place serious. Not you! Not you! No! 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 Well, that's a new thing. Oh wait, that was in another dungeon we probably skipped.
It looks like something from Extreme Build. This is like Ghostbusters. Who are you gonna call?
Speaking of Grade A Nightmare Fuel. I think we actually are on the right track. I remember going through that screen first. Stop poking me with that sword of yours! Nope. Oh, yeah, actually, yes, I want to be on the screen.
Is that a campfire or what?
Okay, yes, we're here! That took less time than I thought! Okay! We're about to do the last boss of the game, man! You know what? Screw you. I don't even have to fight you. Bye! There's the evil one!
Okay. Hold on. It looks like something from Alien Movie with a mix of Ghost Rider and Alien vs. Predator.
It's an alien head on chicken leg or on stilt legs.
That ain't stilt legs. Those look like robot legs. It's like Alien versus Predator.
And we're done.
Automatically, 5 seconds.
That's how easy he is. With a full magic bar in Tilt A, he dies quickly. Oh, it's the king again. You were him in the first episode.
Glad to hear your back safely. It will take time. But the elves and the dwarves will become friends and return to the peace to this land. And
as it used to be.
As it used to be. I will understand you. It's like, I understand you will leave to continue your journey. What a restless guy.
And there's the end, guys.
It's like some slow-ass walk, just like I've just completed my journey. I can go home. It's like I can go home and tell him I'm a man now.
So, we cleared 3 areas in 1 video.
New record.
So, that's Faxanadu. We beat the game, yay!
Which only took us like, what, 5 days?
With only 3 episodes, about an hour each. So what'd you think? Because you were here throughout the entirety of it.
Fuck up game. No comments. No words. No things.
So, and then it goes back to the title screen.
That'd be funny as hell. It's like, no, you have to restart again. You're missing. Like, it's like, look, it comes up on the screen. It's like, 68% done. 68%? Do you want to start a new game? Dink, yes.
So, we finished back! We beat Faxanadu! Yay!
No lie, if you're like the ultimate nerd, it's like, no, if you're like the ultimate gamer, you're like the 68%, that's some bullshit! Do you want to start a new game? Yes, I do! I want 100%!
Technically, we did. The only thing we didn't do was reach max level. That was it.
Well, technically, that's 95.
Get all the titles. I didn't care enough for that. But I got every item in the game. That's all I care. Aside from... No. Tell a lie. The only item I did not buy was the small shield. That was it.
It's so pointless.
Because I had the magic shield already at that point.
It's kind of pointless, like, buying a small shield. It's like downgrading from frickin'... It's like, no, it's like downgrading from, like, fucking getting Daedric armor to downgrading to, like, fucking iron armor.
Oh, you're... Oh, no, it's like in Terraria when you go from, like, hallowed armor and break back down to wood.
Oh, it's like, technically, it's like, oh, it's technically using this. I've been using technically...
You like to use that word a lot.
In technic what?
Technically.
Hmm. I use a shitload of words a lot. The fucking is, like, don't fucking say nothing.
So I have no idea what I'm going to be doing for my next series.
I would suggest an insult game, but damn it. Or just Project or Naruto.
No, if it's going to be a fighting game, it's going to be a one-off. I'm just letting you know that, making that clear right now. I only do actual Let's Play series of games that have more than one part. And Xenoverse was pretty long.
What about Naruto?
I don't have any Naruto games.
You're staring at me, and it's like, you're staring at me with the press. It's like, seriously, you just called me a freaking Naruto fan, you dumbass. What the fuck have I just been saying? I got three Naruto games sitting over there the whole fucking time, just really. Well, no, wait, I think only two, because I sold two. I've only sold fucking two. Congratulations.
So, final thoughts!
I don't know, I never played old school games like this shit, and possibly without graphics.
You never played the NES?
No. Look, I was part of those kids. Look, I didn't get my first game system until I was like fucking 8, and I got an Xbox.
Still remember, because my first game system was the NES, that I actually owned myself. Yes,
well,
it was
here's the thing. Here's the note. My parents are so damn cheap. My first phone was a damn track phone.
Yeah, I think you told us this in the first episode.
Yeah. I got left at the zoo. It took me, they gave me a damn flip phone track phone.
So why did you get left at the zoo?
I had to use the bathroom. Look, it's like one of those kids who like this, look, gotta use the bathroom real quick. Everyone's is like, no, you got the teachers that are fucking patient to go because they're ready to get the fuck home and stop dealing with us. Like, we want fucking peace. We're tired of dealing with kids all fucking day. So we want fucking peace. Go home. Nope. I came out the bathroom, went to the parking lot, bus was gone. I was looking like... Okay, is the zoo closing? Nope, security guard's in, like, Everyone is like, I'm guessing the teacher didn't do a damn head count and all that shit, or thought everyone was here. I told, like, a few people, hey, I gotta go to the bathroom real quick. I'll be right back, just don't let anyone, it's like, tell the teacher. Obviously, you have those people, it's like, obviously, it's kids, I ain't telling shit. Mm-hmm. So, I was at the zoo, everyone got on the bus, got to go home, like, a few minutes afterwards. What the hell I was doing? I was feeding the damn animals. I was literally fist-bumping a damn gorilla, petting a giraffe, and technically feeding a lion. Get some, motherfuckers!
So, did the teacher get in trouble for this?
No! You can damn it's like, no, because if they did, school's is like...
Well, then, how did you eventually get home?
Easy. And it's like, easy, the bus came back, because the freaking zoo just called my... It's like, just called, like, oh, yeah. They actually said the zoo gave... It's like, basically, my teacher gave the zoo her number... Saying, if anything happens, or, like, the kid injured, give me a call. Automatically, they called her. And obviously, you can automatically tell the bus and freaking is like, bus and the teacher were rushing back because they didn't want to get in trouble.
They didn't want to get served.
No, they did not. Because, look, if you know my mom has literally made DirecTV, a few representatives from AT&T, possibly anyone else that's tried to screw us over cry. Literally, everyone in school city knows my mom because of the fact she's not afraid to curse not only you out, she's not afraid to do it in front of your face. I literally mean she has cursed out the principal at her school. And basically said, I will walk the fuck away and not give a shit. Principal's like, no, wait, we can work this out. Obviously, people in the background are saying this, holy shit, Miss Jackie does not play. She does not play. Look, DirecTV, my mom's a huge fan of wrestling. I grew up on that shit because here's what she would usually do. At our old house, kitchen, TV, wrestling. My room, fucking wrestling. Living room and her bedroom, wrestling. I got pissed off to the point at one point I just did like this. Oh yeah, mom, two can play the game. Cartoons, wrestling. Turn it again, you grind it. Cartoons, get your ass in that room. Nick, you're in my room, so technically I'm staying in my room. My dad just came back and said, that boy got a smart mouth, but he got a point. He got a smart mouth, but he got a point. Alright, fine, you're not grounded. Turn to the wrestling. I grew up on watching... We grew up in a house divided where it's like this. She watched extremely crappy wrestling or world's crappy wrestling, which is like, which translate ECW and WCW. I ended up watching Raw because of The Rock, Stone Cold, and my sexy diva of all time, Lita. Yes, everyone liked Trish Stratus because she had boobs and ass. I liked Lita because of the fact I would love to see her moonsault my ass. In the bedroom. I shit you not, she is.
I don't watch wrestling.
You need to, because damn it, man, Lita was flexible as shit! Man, those legs. Fucking hell.
I think we need to wrap up.
Okay.
So, I have no idea what I'm doing next time. It's going to be a little while before I settle on a game. Here's a suggestion.
We flip a coin.
No. Guys, tell me in the comments! Tell me in the comments!
Please,
there
like,
you go.
It's like, please like and subscribe to our videos. We do some stupid shit almost every day.
Like dancing to that one yodeling song from Tekken 6.
or trying to hook Matta with Fatty Patty.
Alright. Alright, guys.
I swear, Strider, we're going to do that one day. We're just going to fucking do that one day.
Alright.
And Matt's word is like, in General's words, he said he's going to hate us for life, but damn it, it'd be worth it.
Okay. Alright. I'll see you guys next time. I'm signing off.
Wait, one more thing. If we do pick a fighting game, I know for a fact General is going to be spamming the shit out of moves.
All he does is shoot Hadoukens!
Dude,
every time he plays a Shoto!
No, look, if you look at Naruto, here's the thing, he actually did. Strider remembers this. He had the fourth Hokage and was spamming Yellow Flash and Rasengans like that. I had the first Hokage and I decided to wait for that one moment. You remember that, Strider? My life was like this. Down because of all that spamming.
You had the magic pixel.
Look, my life was like down to that 1%. His life was full health. Nope, what happened was, if you know who the first Hokage was, he used wood style, which is controlling fucking trees. I raped his ass in 1 fucking minute! It was funny as hell, he was just doing this. He thought he can get behind me. Nope, wait for it. Strider remembers it. Into the tree. He was hitting the controller so damn fast, messing up, saying, no! I was hitting it calmly as shit, getting criticals every moment. All you just saw was my character just do this. Get him in this tree, hit him, clap, is like, make a giant-ass tree with his corpse almost spread out in fucking crucifix kind of thing, and said, guess what, bitch? I'm about to blow up the tree. Clapped his hands together and the tree ignited into flames. He ended up losing to my 1%.
Alright, I'll see you guys next time.
We are so fucked. We are such fucked up friends. I blame the internet and porn. Well, no, I can't blame porn. Porn, you say? Find me real quick. Blackstone got his phone. And in the bathroom. Oh, look, some magical lotion!
Bye.